I was ready to leave the Scorpions, and I wrote this tongue-in-cheek kind of lyric, you know, not to be taken too seriously. And that's all I can say, you know. I was young, I was a little full of myself, you know, and I thought, yeah, I gotta move on. And it was a decision that I just had to make, you know. I could have, of course, stayed in the Scorpions, and I would have continued to fit into the music, because if you look at particularly this album, Taken by Force, you know, because a lot of people say, oh yeah, he did just this Hendrix thing all the time. On the previous album, yes, but on Taken by Force, with Sales of Sharonis, that's not like Hendrix, you know, and I was already developing away, and had I carried on with the Scorpions, I would have always supported the melodies, because when Klaus and Rudolf wrote a song, it was always great, and it was always very easy to come up with just the right kind of something. And I always enjoyed that process, you know. And afterwards, that I missed that, because it was inspirational to work with particularly those two. I learned a lot from them in the beginning, because I remember coming from a band called Dawn Road, and we were much more experimental, you know, rock meets classical and all this highbrow stuff. And the first thing I realized when I met Rudolf and Klaus, first thing I realized was
these guys are crazy.
No. They, maybe yes, I tell you something else about that. But the first thing I realized was these guys know how to write simple melodies, but great melodies, you know? Whereas I was always more into these violin concertos and everything. And I thought, by being with them, you can learn something, you know? And I wanted to also find that way of doing something just with a few notes and hitting home, you know? And Klaus and Rudolf had that from the beginning.
I was very influenced, no question about this, by Jimmy Page very much too, because Jimmy, he found always ways to present rock in different ways. And this second album of Led Zeppelin, which was only acoustic, had a very special flavor. He found a way to really also let the acoustic guitar rocking. And that's what I tried to do by myself, and found this ring, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding. It's one of those rock songs. I think it had a cool riff, you know. I like the song, you know.
It was experimental metal.
Yeah. Had an experimental vibe, and it was a straightforward rock song.
And yeah, I the same thing. I had this song on my tape machine called Klaus. Sometimes even played it over the phone to Klaus. I said, Klaus, how do you like this song? Oh, that's interesting. Next time we see us, bring a song with you. So when I was bringing the song to him, and mostly it was the guitar and the singing, the melody and everything, but the lyrics, of course, was part of Klaus' stuff. Later on, of course, in the digital times, it was more easy, because yeah, there was a drum computer in the computer. You could play to the computer. Mostly in these times, I played with a click track, or maybe with a kind of a drum computer, Lin drum or something like this, where I could build a rhythm and play through it. So that was right all the time.
Look on the sky when it's time for me to.